Good evening, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Oxygen Not Included. So, unfortunately, last time we ran into a bit of issues, and unfortunately, we lost Mary from our colony. However, we can choose a new person, and since I no longer have a good researcher, let's hope that we can select somebody that will be a nice fit. For example, Otto, that has +4 science, seems like a good plan to welcome to our colony. So welcome, and let's immediately assign a skill point, advanced research. I am hoping that you also be able to do field research at some point, so that we can analyze this thing as soon as we can take the proper measures, or that we have some other way of knowing that it won't erupt for a certain amount of time. Also, it looks like our water supply is getting lower and lower, so either we have to go and collect some water, or we have to extend our pump a little bit. There is some water here, so I probably... Let's just plan that. Let's see if we can collect this all. So let's just empty out this. Maybe get it down to this area so that we can collect it. We will get rid of this ladder or this wall, and then a ladder down here. I am also thinking of converting this area into a space where I can pump some carbon dioxide, so we can let these mushrooms grow, because now that the coal generators are disabled, we no longer have enough carbon dioxide. Also, why do I not have power? Let's see, that's temperature, this is power. Did I turn this off at some point? This switch? No. Wait, why don't we have power? Oh, yeah, I hate that. It always... I know I deconstruct something, but I usually only want to destruct some kind of a wall and not everything. Oh well, this will be a quick fix, at least. So that's something. Plumbing, liquid pump, let's add it right here. With a bit of pipe going up the ladder. We already have the pipe from last time, when we emptied out this area. So that's a good thing I left that in place. Like so. They will get soggy feet, but I hope they'll live. Also, I have to open this one to allow my tubes to get in that area. It won't be a huge area, but it would be just nice to have a couple of planters. I will even add an extra airlock here and replace this airlock as well for an automatic airlock. Just so that we have easy access and we don't really vent a lot of carbon dioxide in our base if we are going to, I guess, pressurize this a bit. We might be able to use it for storage as well, but I don't really want to make it really pressurized. And again, I use R instead of O to rotate. I keep forgetting that it's the other command. So you can work on that. I also decided to go ahead and dig this out, just so that we can store a bit more hydrogen. But I am not sure yet how this will work. There are a lot of germs. We can store them here. Maybe we need to store them in a chlorine environment so that we get, I don't know, so that it gets disinfected automatically without effort from us. Also, we have a lot of water here and might also drain that down into this area. Maybe I'll just mine it and then let it flow. Everybody will get soggy feet, but it will automatically go there. Might be better. Oh well, let's first get this. So I see that my breathability is really low. Do I have not enough oxygen? I really don't understand this statistics, because it seems like we have plenty of oxygen. Maybe because I opened this or something, or there is not a lot here. I can add a few airflow tiles just to make it a bit more flowable, sort of say. I also want to vent the gases from here, the hydrogen that's stuck, so I'm just going to mine out a bit here so that we can let it flow up, and then I will make an air pump with a filter there so that we can get it. How are you? You don't have power. Why not? Did I misclick? Apparently I misclicked. Oops, let's make it a high priority. I also keep an eye on this one. If it's getting broken, then I will replace it by something else. I believe gold has a larger temperature range before it it will damage itself. So in order to prevent from going there too often, I will use the other tiles. So let me just check what if it uses water or dirty water. Do you require anything? Oh, you do. Oh, you do require slime, darkness. So apparently you don't need a lot of water, I guess. So in that case, I will just add planter boxes or farm tiles. I'm not sure if farm tile is better than planter box. This is used as floor. Or maybe I use the I will start with this and we'll see how it goes. Again, I'm out of power. Why? No hydrogen? Pipe blocked? Ah. Again, the same issue. Sorry, guys. I'm just not really used to. I believe I had it. Maybe there's a setting or something that would only allow you to district the top item. I'm not 100% sure. I have to look it up at some point in time. But we do that another time. So let's add a gas vent here. And where am I going to pump? Maybe I just do it from here. These guys don't really care if they have oxygen or carbon dioxide. So if we get a gas pump here and we have a gas filter, maybe just place it here somewhere. It doesn't really matter. Let's rotate it and let's get some gas pipe and do it nicely through the wall like so. I know this costs more resources, but it will look a bit nicer. And then add a gas vent right here so we can ventilate the good gases out again. Power is restored, it's running again, thank you very much. I will select or either copy you into here, and I will probably deconstruct. I will just go ahead and deconstruct this one. They're also in the dark, so that might even be better for them, because there might be some illumination here. Alright, you also want power, that is acceptable. There you go, you can access it. And I want to filter out... I might want to change it around. I want... yes, I will change it around, so this will go there. Then I guess I remove this pipe, and then you know what, I will also just move this ventilation gas vent, and I will filter out carbon dioxide. This will also need power, so let's go ahead and run some power to it. And I do like having either the power switched or some kind of an automation switch so that they can easily turn it on or off whenever I think it is convenient without the need for a juke to go there. So is it working? That's plumbing, this is ventilation. You just need this and there is no access again. You know what? I will create a small tunnel so that they can access that. And also access the Oh no. How did this bridge? Oh, it sent. The sand fell down. Yeah, well, in that case, I'm just going to dig it all out. And this will be pumped back up, so I do want to mop it here, but we'll let it flow first and then we'll mop it. Let's close this one for now so that it doesn't go into there, because I really wanted here to fill up this tank. And please go do this quickly. Let's cancel this, by the way, and do this first so that all the resources drop down and I don't need to enter the tank. Also disable this one so that we are not spilling water. Or did I? No. That's why I want a button. I want to be able to now disable this liquid pump without the need for a duplicate to go to it, disable it. If it's a switch like here, I can just go and click and bam, the pump is disabled without someone needing to go there. So that's very convenient, in my opinion. So, alright, that has been fixed. I might as well lower it a bit. Maybe something like this. Yeah, why not? I don't really need that much water in there, as long as there is a steady supply of water in there. Excellent. Please build, and then I will enable this thing again. So, just a small water tank, but it should provide me with plenty of water. We are also mopping up all the liquids. That's excellent. This will slowly fill. Unfortunately, it will take some time. Might also go ahead and really try to dig out this area so that we can get this water. Unfortunately, there's no easy way I can pump that out, but I might as well just add a pump there. So that will be fine, I think. How are these guys doing? They are growing. Excellent. Unfortunately, there's too much liquid there. Can't really mop that up. But as soon as they go into the airlock once, it will be fine. You, as my thing is full, my stables, I will just kill you and get a bit of meat. Excellent. Perfect. So my dupes can now cook some nice things. Can you please go and mop up this liquid? Still no. I have to wait for a dupe to you. Move to somewhere around here just to open this door. Can I now mop it up? Not yet. Can I now mop it? Yes, excellent. Perfect. This is going nicely. This is going nicely. And then I might have to place a pump there. I do get a lot of sick duplicants, so I might want to build a few more medicines. I did store them all in here. Curative tablet is... Oh, I might need to build a couple. This is coal and water, so let's add 25 or something like that. Oh, it only does food poisoning. I'm not sure what I need for like a hypothermia or something. This might also be nice. It's just coal. Let's try to make 99. Because I do get a few sick people, so add 2 airflow tiles here to get rid of that gas. Add 1 tile here so it doesn't get stuck in that pocket. And then I'm hoping it will flow to the left. I might need to convert this into an airflow tile. It will probably get stuck here, and that is fine for now. But I can use this area to get rid of the gas, the gases. Alright, let's also check the research. I haven't checked that in some time. Is my research done for automation? It is. I now have the end gates. Excellent. What else do we need? I think I probably want to go to hazard protection so that we can analyze those things. I'm gonna be out of power again. Did I Yes, of course I destroyed. There was probably a wall here, right? Yeah. I will just add doors and then I can run the wire. I also noticed that it's starting to get a bit strained, my power network. I don't see a lot of damages yet, but at some point in time I'm going to need to use the heavy watt wire. Unfortunately, it cannot be run through walls or floor tiles, so I need to go behind ladders or something like that and maybe create a couple of small substations at the edge of the base instead of doing it another way. I will add a liquid pump here just because that's easier than to dig everything out, and it will cost some resources, but I will get them back if I move it. Wires. And whoop. There we go. Just temporarily until everything is drained. This is nicely full of carbon dioxide. That's exactly what I want for those mushrooms. Please also mop this water. There we go. And also sweep this area. Are we still overcrowded? We are still overcrowded, so I am going to kill one or two. I'm not sure if I can set it to automatically kill them or something like that. And I'm also not really sure when it's considered overcrowded and how to manage it. I never really worked with them a lot, so it still says it's overcrowded, so I'm going to kill just two more, see if that fixes it. If it doesn't fix anything, at least I got some free meat out of it. So now it's just glum. I'm not sure why. Perhaps you don't get enough attention. Your happiness is down. So, do we have any eggs? Nope. It doesn't look like we have any eggs. Alright. Let's see. This is now working perfectly. This is working perfectly. We have water again. That's excellent. We can also choose something. So let's choose a blueprint. Machinery. Decorating. Not that fantastic. I don't think I really need another duplicate at this point in time, so we'll just go for some bristleberries and then just wait. Oh, and probably you are going to eat it? I don't know. Skills. I also see that we have a lot of skill points waiting. What do you want to do? You don't love anything else, so I guess we can assign you to operating. You would like to be a better critter ranger. That's great. You can do this. Hazmat digging is also a nice trait to have, I think. Advanced medical care. Fantastic. We definitely need more medical care so that we can rescue our dupes if things go wrong. You don't really want to do anything, so let's assign you to let's do construction. And you want to do farming, and you also want critter ranching. All right, perfect. How's our stress levels? 6%. That's fantastic. We have a massage table, and just for their likings, if they want it, they can use it. All right, excellent. So I'm wondering, do I already need to go and do some cooling? It's starting to get hot in the base, so I might try to discover the area around here a bit more. And also it looks like my storage is getting full, so let's add a few more storage bins. Maybe that's why they're not sweeping. like those resources. And also there are a lot of resources around here. It can be swept. And yes, I decided to go ahead and open this. I'm not sure what's going to happen. They might all get sick. But that's a risk we need to take because, yeah, I really never messed with the slime that much. I always kind of avoided it wherever possible, but it's in such a spot that I really like it to be gone so that I can add some storage tanks. Because we are now wasting some hydrogen because it can't properly vent. So I will select this for digging. And I will cancel something like this so that the dirty water gets trapped here before it flows down there. We also need to add some tiles right here so that we don't vent the hydrogen in there. I will open this door so that I can do it from the top, probably before I dig this out. I know this will hurt your eyes, but it's for a good cause. If you can just fix that quickly. Unfortunately, you just didn't do that yet. But if you get that done, then I am sure that no hydrogen can escape because I don't want any more hydrogen in my base. Picking up a fungal spore. Can you please just fix this thing? That would be fantastic. It would be also nice to have the mini gas pump so we can put this into a vacuum so the hydrogen doesn't escape as easily into my base. Is this now leaking? I really hope not. But let's see. Research. I have the hazmat suit, so that's nice. And now let's see where we have the mini air pumps. I would say it's under gases. But I am not really seeing it yet. It might also be in liquids because I found out that some things prefer to hide in the liquids. But yeah, I am not really seeing it. Gas canisters, oxygen masks. Transit tubes? No. Maybe it got removed. That would be bad. Or scrubbers, water, sieves. Well, we might find it at some point. Just not at this point in time, I guess. I have no idea. Oh, it's here because it needs plastic. Yeah, so we're not going to do that for now. I am just going to go for some in this area because at some point I will probably want to cool the water, or at least cool the air at my base, and I might use water for that. But yeah, don't I have enough copper? I should have enough copper, right? Yeah, 1500 kilos. Maybe I need to make a bit more refined copper because I have a lot of copper ore stored. Just to prevent it from running out. Also, my power is working perfectly. Are you going to fix it? No. Can someone, in the name of God, please fix this tile? Thank you very much. And now I will lock this door again. Now we can dig out this. And then we can... let's make sure we do something like this first before anything else. Ah, it probably will flow to the left. Yes. No. Now it's going to fall down there. I don't want it. A tile with emergency priority. Please. Is anyone going stuck? Maybe. Ah no, it's dripping. Let's disable this building. Shit. Shit, 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 shit. Disable building emergency. I might, as a matter of emergency, just kill all power. Does this kill all power? No, because we still have batteries. Unfortunately. Now all power is killed. Ah, this is already disabled. Fantastic. Let's turn you on. Let's make sure to mop this up. I did my best to not get all the water in my base, and yet I still got all the water in my base. However, we can go to plumbing and we can go to extract pipe contents and just empty out this pipe. And I think that we were here just in time, building the tile and getting the power, that we don't have too much, or really we don't have any dirty water there yet. So I'll just wait a moment until they mop this all up. And yeah, then I will try and see what the pipe, empty pipe does. I really hope we have someone that can do that. Let's check out the skill tree. You can, yeah, you can do it, for example. So that will be just fine. Any other liquids that are still somewhere? No. All the gases are vented from here. That's also very nice. Carbon dioxide is there. How is my oxygen looking? Oxygen is looking really good. Receiving some polluted oxygen right here. Might be worth getting a deodorizer here. And I believe they used power. Yes, they do. Just in case that dirty oxygen is getting into my base, then it will be cleaned by this thing. Guys, can you please fix this? Please. Priority 9, maybe. And also get this. Alright, but I'm going to end this episode right here. I will wait a moment before quitting so that they can empty this pipe, so we don't have to wait on that next time. But thank you all for watching, and I see you again the next time.